Everyone, so today we are going to discuss new experiment. So the experiment name is called as burden tube and LVT. By using this burden tube and LVT, you can measure what your pressure. Okay, so LVT is again passive transducer, and burden tube is also one of the example for what your mechanical transducer. Okay, so you can give the bellows is one of the example for what mechanical transducer. Diaphragm is also one of the example for what mechanical transducer. By using this one, you can measure what your pressure. Okay, so this is the setup which you are going to use by what your pressure gauge. So this is what your pressure gauge in terms of what two types. One is for what your kg, and the other one is for what your psi. That psi stands for what? Pounds per square inch. And one more, you are going to use one transducer. That transducer name is called as what? Burden tube. Okay, so by using these two, one is for what your pressure gauge, as well as what another one is for what? Burden tube. You can measure what your pressure. Okay, so this side. So this is the setup which you are going to use by what today experiment. Okay, so this one is called as a foot pump. So by using this foot pump, you can apply your pressure by using what your leg. So next one is what? One more pressure gauge is there. So by using this pressure gauge, you can measure what your output. So here two valves are there, or two knobs are there. One is for what? Pressure input. So whatever you are going to apply this pressure, this will move towards what? This tube or this pipe. So that will comes towards the what? This pipe. Okay, so that whatever that pressure is there, so that will move towards the what? This pressure regulator. So once this pressure will move towards the what? High point. So then if you want to take the next reading, so that time you have to release your pressure. So that purpose you have to use for what? This pressure regulator. So every time you have to release your pressure, make it that one as for what? Zero. So once it will zero, again you have to apply your pressure and you have to take the new reading. So next one, your hand on display. So digital display. So by using this digital display, you can measure the displacement. So whatever display you are getting that reading, you can take that reading and you have to write down. So this is what you are performing experiment. So first we'll take the reading. So this is the tabular column. Okay, so first tabular column is what? Weight in psi. Weight in psi. Second one is the output. Output in the foot pump. And third one is the displacement in mm. Okay, so first I am going to apply my weight in PSI, that is the pounds per square inch, or in terms of what? Kg per centimeter square. Okay, so you have to apply in terms of what? Pounds per square inch. So these are the SI units which you are going to use by what? In terms of two units. First one is the pounds per square inch. Second one is the kg per centimeter square. So that is in terms of what? SI units. Okay, so British system you can measure in terms of what? PSI. So that is the pounds per square inch. And in SI units you can measure in terms of what? Kg per centimeter square. Okay, so first I will apply my first reading. So that is what I will put form. I will apply this one. So once you are getting this one, apply your pressure for foot pump. You are getting in terms of what? That is the range in terms of what? 0 to up to what? 150. So that is in terms of what? PSI. So you are having what? 20. So 20 PSI is the first reading. You can write it here. So here you can write it. Weight in kg, then you have to apply your output in foot pump. Okay, so sorry, so you have to take that is in terms of what? Foot pump. In terms of, it's okay, no problem at all. You can take in weight in psi 20, and output in foot pump you can take in terms of what? That is the in terms of psi, red color it will shows 20, 22. So compare these two, you are getting what? 2 is the difference. Error is what? 2. So displacement is what? 0.06. You can write it here. So next, you have to release the pressure by using this regulator. Once you release, it will make it what? 0. Okay, so it will come back to what your original position. So again, you have to apply the pressure for what? New reading. I will apply this one. So you are getting the reading is what? Near about 40. So 40 is what your PSI in terms by using what your pressure input. So next you are getting the reading is what? Near about 30. Whatever that indication of what your small section of red line is there. 2, 2, 2. That is 32, 34 and 36. Okay. So you can write it here. 30. In between you are having what? 38. So 38 is what your weight in PSI. Output is what your 36. Okay. So displacement is what? Not changing. You can write it here. 0.06. So next reading, again you have to release the pressure, make it 0, and again tighten the regulator, and again you have to press this one, and you are getting what, near about 40 to 50 in between. So means what, you are getting the 44. You can write it here 44. Then here you can take what, near about 42. And there is no change in, yes, it is change in displacement. We will get what, 0.07. So next, again release the pressure by using this knob. Okay, so again you have to apply the pressure by using this one. It is exactly what, your 40 you are getting here. So here you are getting the near about 40, that is what, your 38. And there is no change, 0.07, you can write it here. So means what? So in this experiment, if you want to measure your pressure by using Bardol tube as well as what, your LVDT. So first, LVDT is a passive transducer. Okay. So you can convert your what, your first input signal into what, first of all in the displacement. So that displacement will be converted in the form of what? Electrical signal. That is what is getting that electrical signal. So here LVDT act as a input, and again the Bardol tube act as a output. Okay. So you can interchange this one. Bardol tube act as a input and LVDT act as a output. So again, LVDT is one of the example for what, passive transducer, and Bardol tube is one of the example for what, your mechanical transducer. Okay, so where are you going to do this experiment? So nowadays in every shop you are going to checking the your in terms of what, your that pressure. Okay, so it may be what, two-wheeler, or it may be what, four-wheeler. Okay, so in bikes as well as what, in four-wheelers, you are going to checking by using this kind of the instrument. So in two-wheelers as well as what, in four-wheelers, you are going to use for what, this experiment. Okay, so in terms of PSI, allows what, in terms of kg per centimeter square. So thank you.